I find that for people, there's an emotional connection once you understand where your food comes from. I try and make people more aware of, get out to the farmer's market. You know, understand the people that are growing the food that you're eating.
Welcome back, everyone. We're talking about becoming a vegan, and my next guest is Lainey Friedrich, a vegan coach. And you know, we want to start by discussing, Lainey, the nutritional needs, right? When somebody becomes a vegan, what should they think about as far as nutritional needs for themselves?
Well, the first thing is you're going to be asked a lot of questions. All of a sudden, everyone's going to be worried about where you get your protein from.
Yes!
So you might as well start to learn that. So you want to understand the macronutrients, which are protein, fat, and carbohydrates, because again, people are going to ask you about how you're fulfilling those needs. And then there's the micronutrients, which you'll get from eating a lot of intact food, a lot of eating from the rainbow food. So I think starting there, just understanding protein needs. Most people don't understand how many grams they need. Most people say, oh, I get my protein from something, but they don't track it.
Right.
So I teach people how to track their protein grams.
And I think you said something very important, because you're going to get a lot of questions about people that are worried, like you're going to like pass out because you're and people don't realize for thousands of years, lots of populations and civilizations have not only survived, but thrived because of being vegans. So what's the connection, though, between, you know, we talk about physical health, emotional health, and having the nutrients that vegans do. Can you make that connection? Because people forget that what they eat can affect their mental health as well as their physical health.
Absolutely. I find that for people, there's an emotional connection once you understand where your food comes from. I try and make people more aware of, get out to the farmer's market. You know, understand the people that are growing the food that you're eating. And when you cut up your own vegetables, even in the kitchen, it's really just a refreshing experience. When I cut up a lemon, I mean, that brightens me up. And when I can look at a salad bar that I put together with all my favorite vegetables in there, it's like old friends every day at lunchtime. Seriously, you start to have this enjoyment of food that I think a lot of us who are eating fast, we're eating processed foods, you lose that enjoyment from food.
And I think you get connected back to, I think, your roots. You know, when we talk about this, we're talking about going back to nature, because that's where these foods came from. And you feel a sense of connection. I do. And the other thing is that get your kids involved. If you have kids, and get them involved, because then they can become part of the process. But going back to your macro and micronutrients, how is that affecting your physical health? Because people don't always put it together. They go, I'm always tired, but they don't always put together that what you're eating can affect that. Oh. Maybe you can talk about that a little bit, because I think one of the things that many of my patients that go to veganism or vegetarian or more plant-based, they say, I feel better. I'm not as bloated. I have more energy. Maybe you can speak to what's the correlation there?
Sure. I find that people, when they first switch over, they're purging a lot of toxins out of their body, so they get a lot more energy. And then the longer that they do this, if they're not watching those micronutrients and the macronutrients, then they start to get a little bit lethargic, because they're taking things out of their diet, they're eliminating the animal products, but they're not substituting back in to bulk up the protein and the fat and the carbohydrates and just getting enough calories. You have to eat a lot more food, you get hungry more often. So that's one of the things that I tell people. Peanut butter and jelly is literally a great snack for people starting out.
Sure.
And also raw nuts. So if you just need a quick snack, they're easy to store, or dried nuts. So things like that, that's what my pantry looks like.
You know, in my car, I always have nuts. Because, you know, because when you get hungry, and those of you who are watching, you know that if you folks get hungry, they go and reach for what? Potato chips, or they're passing by the amazing fast food restaurant, they go through and get something horrible. This is how you set up your life, I think, to be successful, is just like you said, have those staples available wherever you are so you can make things happen. People don't know that broccoli has protein. And she talked about beans. I think legumes, L-E-G-U-M-E-S, don't get enough love, right?
Right.
So legumes have tons of protein. wonderful complex carbohydrates. So remember, two of those building blocks you already have. And then if you give healthy fats, like with things like avocados, things like, you know, for example, extra virgin olive oil, you've got it made. And the thing is, to help people do it gradually. I think that, you know, some people can do it as a quick switch. We met a couple that could do it immediately, but most people, it's a gradual shift.
You just swap it out.
Yeah, and then also, I think that knowing how you feel, one of the biggest things I see with people is that once they feel better, it's just like when you lose weight. When you start losing weight, you're like, I want to be on this diet. Once you start feeling better, I think it helps. Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Parthanandi. And if you enjoyed that video, you're gonna love the next one. It's full of incredible information to help you start your health hero journey.